for the last 2 days, and well, we don't know what we got done yet. We haven't had a rehearsal. This is going to be our rehearsal. But anyway, we're certainly open to enjoy yourself, and the first thing we're going to open with is the Hope to Newfoundland, following by a welcome recitation.
Join the elections, turn the parade on.
next announcement, I got to say something that I forgot first. There's one a few other things. We got a birthday girl here tonight. Got a little girl, Melanie Porter, she's 5, and I'd like for her to come up. Come on, Melanie.
Come on, it's great to see you. There she is, 5 today.
Now, the next skit is a carry-on from last year. How many of us was here last year? Oh, well, this skit, you'll know all about the people, characters that's in it. Ari Cyrix and Elvira is back. The only thing this year, Ari's in a bit more trouble, or Elvira is over your mind to look at it, than they were last year.
Doctor, I'm calling about Harry. He's been acting very strange lately. I know he drinks a bit, but this is something different. Sometimes he thinks he's an elephant, sometimes a horse or a rooster, or anything. He's hurt now, and when he comes in, maybe he'll think he's the Loch Ness Monster. I don't know what to do with him. So if I should call you through the evening, would you come over and check him out, please? Sometimes he's enough to scare the daylights out of him. Okay, thank you very much. I'll just holler across, just holler up to you. I won't bother calling. Okay? Thank you.
Finger.
There's a new invention I made myself.
see, there he's going crazy. See, if you got the hemorrhoids and the staff itch, see, that'll drive them foolish.
Somewhere.
I just got a little machine there I invented myself. It's called an hemorrhoid pusher.
Oh.
Or you could call it a pile driver.
Preparation H.
knows.
Grave.
was up to the post office, the package came today, and every man and woman was up there.
Oh, it was a one of your own yet.
You got a letter from Jack.
I was wondering. That's what I've been waiting for. Open it up. You got an egg left? Hurry up.
Give me glasses, maid. See what he says.
Well, cleans them all up. Oh, I wonder what he's doing now. Hurry up. I've been waiting this 2 weeks to see how he's doing.
Dear mother and father, Valera is still up here in Toronto. I don't know when I'll get home. I got me 10 weeks, but now I can't get laid off. If I quit, I won't get me unemployment.
Poor Jad, she's some unlucky, ain't he?
Why, the shocking, you know. The shocking. Yeah.
Ridiculous. Poor fella.
I'm working in this big rubber factory up here. And there's such a big demand for rubber these days that I might never get laid off. We make rubber boots and rubber bands and rubber tires, and we even make condoms.
For lava sticks.
Well, I'm not sure. But I hears about the crowd that goes to Florida. They lives in them. Newfoundland since the moratorium. Anyway, he says, by father, there's some stunt crowd up here, and they ask the foolishest questions. The boss sent me down to the lumber yard last week to get some 2x4s. And the fella there asked me how long did I want him. And I say, sure, the boss wants him for a long time. Because he's going to build a house.
He's so smart, ain't he, Jad?
He's a smart. They don't come much smarter than Jad.
They don't. No, sir.
Every time you write, you ask me when is I going to get married. Sometimes I thinks it might be all right to have a woman. But it was easy for you, father. You married mother. But I'd have to marry a strange woman.
Poor fella. You find someone don't want those things. Back here, crinkle comb. He could ever get home.
I hope he's as lucky as I was to get you.
He will.
He said, I seen this fella on the street the other day. And I says, that's me cousin Jake. So I bawled out to him, and I run the carton, and he looked at I, and I looked at he, and I sized him up. But then I found out that it wasn't here one of us.
Sure, he should have known that Jake's not in Toronto.
That's right, sure. Do you know where Jake is?
I know he never went to Toronto.
Right. He's sure he's on the moratorium.
That's right. He's not going all that spell like our judge.
I won't get on to go trouting. Seems like I won't make it now.
Sure, there's no odds anyway. Sure, if he can only catch a dozen, can't he?
Yes.
But that's only a meal for us.
And that he wouldn't make a good meal.
No.
Well, that's all for now. I don't know when I'll get home. Your loving son, Judge. P.S. Tell Mother I'm sending her a clothesline, but I'm having trouble finding a box long enough to put it in.
song. Ever have a job to find a lot to tell you the truth?
Fisherman down by the sea, have you any lobsters for to sell to me? Singing yo-tiddly-o, 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 tiddly-o, oh, oh. Yes, sir, I have three, the biggest kind of lobsters you have ever seen. Singing yo-tiddly-o, 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 tiddly-o, oh, oh. I took the lobsters home, I put them in the pot, I put them in the pot where the missus used to squat. Singing yo-tiddly-o, 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 tiddly-o, oh, oh. Well, early next morning, as you can plainly see, this hop jumps the missus for to do her pee. Singing yo-tiddly-o, 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 tiddly-o, oh, oh. First I heard a scream, then I heard a groan, then I saw the lobster.
Girl.
liver and coleslaw? What kind of grub is that?
Good healthy grub. You've been eating too much lately. And now it's time I started feeding you some vitamins.
Vitamins? What's that mean, vitamins?
Vitamins is little things in your food that keeps you healthy. There's iron in the liver, and that's good for you too.
Iron? Who needs iron? Sure, I could go down the stage and put my ass on a rake wheel and say, I get iron enough. She's going to be after everything else killed in the cold. From a bluebird to Merv's goats. Trying to get the liver out of it.
Well, we're changing our eating habits from now on. Bill Rowe and Ben Jameson is always talking about good foods. They knows everything. And another thing, Bess says, smoking is bad for you. And it's time for you to give up that. There's too much nicotine in that.
Tell me, mate, you're going to take away me fish and brews, but you're missing getting me back, eh? What now I wouldn't give for a good feed of fish and brews and scrunchions all over the top. I'm nearly starved to death. She's been mixing up this crap now for a couple of weeks. And it's getting worse and worse.
Well, I'll cook the fish if you want fish. No, that's no problem. But I won't be cooking any brews with it. There's too much starch in those. And everyone knows the starch and proteins don't mix.
Separating fish and brews. See, that's like separating man and wife. You can't separate fish and brews. Next thing you'll be separating pork and cabbage.
You got that right. Too much grease in there. Next thing your gallbladder will be acting up and giving me more trouble. I'm going out up the doors now and see if I can get some tomatoes and celery. And I'll have a tossed salad for supper.
Celery, tomatoes, broccoli, lettuce, what crap? Vitamins. I'm nearly starved to death. My grandfather lived to be 95. He never eat none of that grub. No fish and brews. No pork and cabbage. No peas pudding and boiled duck. Since we've been eating this stuff, I've had trouble with my bowels, too. I never took a dose of sauce in my life. And since she started cooking that, every day I'm taking a pack of sauce. And then there's nothing comes from me, only small gravel. I got an idea and then I might cure all this. See what I can do about all this. There she comes.
Oh. Well, I got the tomatoes and the celery. Now for the salad. Oh my, what's wrong, Ward? What's wrong?
Will he be all right?
Yes, he's grown. Have you been eating anything different lately?
Oh, I've been feeding on some of those healthy foods.
Healthy foods?
Yes, like lettuce and broccoli and liver and...
Oh, broccoli and liver, all that good stuff.
Yes.
Well, that's it.
Is he going to be all right?
Yes, I think he is. That's it. He's got a complete reverse to his digestive system due to overdose appointments.
Say that again, Doc.
You've been eating too many appointments and not enough your regular food.
Oh, I'm getting better already. Oh, to see that, mate?
Yes, I heard it.
Go and put that bread to soak and I'll get the fat back for the luncheon. I'm going to have a feed of yourself a fresh and brew.
Yes, you'll be feeling
moratorium
better.
Moratorium or no moratorium?
You'll be feeling better by tomorrow.
Will you stay for a bit of supper, Doc?
I don't know if I will.
Yeah. Yeah, have a bite.
Right on.
Hurry up, mate.
Wanted a wife who can cook.
Away, friend. I want
Colton girls. And in this one, Meg and Liz Hammer is back with us again here. If you remember last year, there was a big tar up over the moratorium. Things seem to be looking up for them this year.
Times have certainly changed around here. It's not like it used to be. Nobody ever runs in unless they're invited. And then you've got to have a feast ready for them. Here I sit all alone, knitting and thinking.
I had to come over to see you, Meg. It was such a lovely day. I thought it'd be a fine day for Mama. So I took her mile over here. How is your Meg? I haven't seen her in ages.
My Emma, it's so nice to see you. I was just thinking, something queer is happening around here.
Yes, something queer always happens around here. When there's not one thing, it's another.
Emma, do you ever see Liz? It was about a year ago. We all met here in this very house. Poor thing. She was very disturbed at the time.
Don't go talking about Liz, Meg. I seen her the other day, acting like a teenager. She was as happy as the gulls down on Fox's Rocks. And you know what? She sings like them tools. She's enough to make a horse throw up his oats.
I always thought she was a little off. But I thought it was worrying over the moratorium.
She'll be coming round the mountain. Round the mountain she comes.
Speak off the devil, Meg, and you sure will appear. Here's Liz coming up the road now. Don't be frightened when you see her. She's not the Liz that you used to know.
Good morning, good morning.
Try. You're some fool.
you won't be sorry, Meg. I think I'll start with your eyebrows. They says that's the first thing a man looks at is your eyebrows.
It's not the first thing a man went for when I was in my prime. Hey, John.
sour smell.
Bye. champion. Huggies or Pampers? I know it's going to be quite a load to handle, but hang on to your seats. Representing Huggies from up the harbour, weighing in at 240 pounds, plus the load in the back of the diaper, is Herb Bob Huggity.
And they're open that the title don't give nothing away.
speak. They knew I had the cough. They knew I had the sneezes. They should have let me off. So now I suppose that I'm here. I'll do the best I can. Oh, goodness gracious me. Here comes another sneeze again. I must give up. It's just no good. I tried my best, oh well. I think I'll go back home again and have a sneezing spell.
Like was announced, the song is fairly new. But anyway, we're going to have a little bit of fun with the politicians on this one. Like it was announced earlier, this one, Harris World itself. So you just pay close attention to the words and you'll get the meaning of the song.
Some say the word.
From the back, for Sandra.
suppose you're guilty of killing, stealing, killing, and cooking and mad as sheep. But I think it'll be $200 I can get your dog.
Okay. Why, I'll tell you some lawyer. If I ever get in any more trouble, I'll be sure and call you.
Oh, well, thank you. You was a great client. Remember now also there was a small fee of $200. Can you pay today?
Thank you. Hello. Good night, audience. I'm Tommy O from CHBO, 560 on your dial, the best in the bay. And I'm here tonight to do this fashion show for the people here. You know, we're a bit long, but you know how it is in the fashion industry. Now, my co-host tonight is supposed to be Carl Wells. But now you know where Carl Wells is too. He could be out on Pier Island checking out the goals. He's always late. Anyway, I told him down to work I didn't want to come up here tonight. And, well, they talked about laying me off. And they said, well, we'll give you 2 steps if you'll go up here tonight. So that's the kind of stuff you know. Oh, here's Carl now. Oh, there he is. I thought you were never going to get there.
I didn't think I was either.
Where's your tour guide?
Oh, it's up on J. Lewis Mountain. Doing tomorrow's weather report.
Any girls up there?
Yeah, lots of them.
Sure somebody here wasn't picked today.
Oh. Nearly gone.
Yes, boy. That's not a place to be to go to winter on top of J. Lewis Mountain.
Anyway, good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I'm very pleased to be one of your hosts for tonight's fashion show. I understand that there's a wide variety of fashions and our models are very anxious to get the show on the road. I've also been told that you can use your door tickets for a 50% discount on any of the outfits you see models there on the stage.
Yes, boy, that's a great bag, that is.
Just take it away, Tommy.
Okay, well, I've been told that we're very privileged tonight to have a visit from our very own Baby New Year. Now, I believe is Baby New Year here yet, I wonder? Oh, there's a little tea.
Oh!
This is Lily's work clothes, which she wears during the night shift on the corner of Duckworth and Queen Street. And by the way, Miss Lily's weekend special is $49.95, and you can pre-order at your earliest convenience. Miss Lily's hair and fashions were provided by Harvey's unique boutique of Shipco, and I'm sure Lily got the something she wants to say.
Tom Pretcham has put me in charge of nutrition. He thinks I can breastfeed the nation. Last night I showed our new minister just what it was Adam was tempted by. He's got a new meaning for the word sin. A present from a truck driver on Hamilton Avenue.
And
May God guide and keep you through a happy new year.